Hi everyone, welcome to my sharing on how to build a real Starship Enterprise Navigation System Astrogation. It's called Astrogation because I think what happens is they plot the stars, all the stars in the universe, and then they plot the location of the Starship based on the location of the star. So they plot and then get the location via the position of all the stars as well. What is the navigation? Is the science of locating position and plotting the course of ships, aircraft, and spacecraft. In last case, the term is referred to as astrogation. So this is a Star Trek history that they actually use the navigation, and it's they have automatic communications. So an astrogation station on uninhabited planet of Gamma 2. So they have the station that actually transmits out the signals as well, to actually help the person to navigate, the ship to navigate. So they have a station, and the time they have automatic communications. I think all this is using AI, because there's this new thing about the AI technology. AI is of course now is still in they are still learning how to use AI, but definitely they will become smarter, and this automatic communications can come to fruition. So probably AI will be incorporated into this to make it a real Starship Enterprise. So but then in another later sequel, right, they have this 792. They create a type of navigation that is navigated by the stars. That one was a navigation system. I'm not sure whether, let me go to the previous one. It's automatic communications, so I think should be a different kind of technology. It's automatic communications, so they have a station that actually plots out the, maybe what the station does is that it actually just send the signals, and then they just communicate, they just detect all the stars to the station. But then I think this one is a different kind. This one is the navigation by the stars. If you see my previous slide, right, you can see this person looking at the star chart of this looks like the Milky Galaxy. So it's a star chart of the Milky Galaxy. But then there's this thing I want to learn about, is that sometimes stars supernova and then it disappears. What are you gonna do? Because stars do supernova. Stars supernova means that it actually just uses all the gases in the star and then it just explodes and then disintegrate into nothing. But there will be bright shining light force, and a force which is explosion of the star. The star do explode and just disintegrate as well. So I was thinking, how are they going to trace the stars if they actually, maybe they trace that it's an empty space, so maybe it has a supernova, in the supernova itself. So the technology worked by astromagnetic sensors and radio flux of 3 billion stars. So they have this star chart, it's a star chart which is the 3 billion stars. So they actually can calculate position relative to the center of the galaxy. So it's a Milky Way galaxy. So I think they travel in a galaxy, Milky Way galaxy itself. There are so many galaxies out there. It's not just our galaxy. So there must be some intelligent life there that also has this navigation technology. But we are in the Milky Way galaxy. So I think probably they travel around the Milky Way. So as you can see from the photo, he's just cracking his mind. How do I travel the most efficient way by charting the stars, and then what's the most efficient route? So it's more accurate than the current technology and multiple fires for the ship journey. So like I say, it's more efficient to do it this way because they can plot out a journey which is actually shorter and faster as well. So this is the new technology. So how are you going to incorporate the real Starship Enterprise? This will be the technology to actually know the star chart, and then to calculate the journey, and then the position, and then the trail of moving from one star to from one solar system to another. So they'll be moving along different solar system and exploring. So this would be I probably think next time space exploration will be very much dependent on the Starship Enterprise, a warship. It's actually a warship as well. It can be a warship. It can be exploration It can also be a transport ship as well, so it has many uses for the Starship Enterprise. For Star Wars, I think I have not gone into the technology they use. I will try to create a video that talks about the navigation system of Star Wars as well. I've already did a video on the lightsaber, so that was very interesting. Please check out my video. I'll leave the link at the description, so please check out my video. And now to further add that one of the ways that you can actually get this star chart is actually very simply just to send satellites around the Milky Galaxy and then just record the number of stars there. I think NASA is actually doing space exploration, is actually discovering all the stars and all the planets. So they are charting out the whole galaxy. So for future space travel. So this is what they are doing now, and then this will work so that they can actually navigate. So it's important to have space exploration is very important for the future space travel. So I think this will be made possible through their efforts. But if we have a starship, we can build a starship just like this, then do space exploration automatically using AI. It's also possible. It's not possible to send a spacecraft without people in it, so that there's no risk involved of losing a crew member. You can actually just navigate the starship just automatically as well. So this is one of the ideas. It sounds like now you have automatic quadcopters in the sky, automatic vehicles in the sky. So now you can have automatic spacecraft which actually can navigate and then chart out all the places. And then they have more power and more fuel. You just have to control them through the long distances, the long distances of the from Earth to the spacecraft. So we can also monitor the situation in the starship to see whether it's suitable for human life, whether they can actually survive in the environment for long periods of time. You can actually do some tests on it with tissue samples. I think that would be helpful as well. So this is just to add on what I want to say for this navigation system. So I thank you for watching. I hope this has been the last thing I want to leave you with is called astrogation. If anybody asks you the terminology of how the navigation system is called astrogation, so this is what I want to leave you with. As if you think that my video is good, please share it. And then I thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel for more updates and leave your comments if you think that you have any thoughts, or you have any new way of making it practical for space exploration for the Star Trek Enterprise, Starship Enterprise. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.